So you heard about hackathons and you want to be a part of one. Well, my name is Adrienne. I'm going to tell you the who, what, when, and why of hackathons. So I just got done participating in the Foursquare Hackathon here in San Francisco. Technically, this is my second hackathon because I also did Startup Weekend in May, although it's called Startup Weekend, not a hackathon. So let's go ahead and just start up with the basics. What is a hackathon? Now, when I mentioned it to a friend of mine, he said, oh, I don't want to be anywhere near one of those hackathons because I don't want my computer hacked into. I said, actually, that's not what a hackathon is. What it is a bunch of people get together, and it's usually focused on a specific language or product, and they build something awesome. It's usually software, but it can be all sorts of things. In fact, I did a blog post over on But You're a Girl, which is my blog, about this. And so usually it's sponsored by a company or an event. Everybody from Foursquare, Twitter, even Salesforce, which is like one of the largest and most successful software companies out there now on the web. You may have heard of them if you are in business. They help you manage your sales and business leads. They're huge. They had a hackathon at their conference. And people attend these conferences for a variety of reasons. Everything from they really love to program to, you know, they want to get better at their skills. They're looking to network with other people. Maybe they started a company and they're looking to hire someone on. So yeah, there will often be like a lot of people scouting for talent. Maybe they have a startup and they're looking for someone that they can pair up with as a co-founder. That's also really popular as well. And some people just want to have fun. I mean, they're just like, I'm into this. Now, who goes to these? Well, at first I thought that it was like all developers, right? And I myself am learning Ruby on Rails, so I still don't feel like a full-fledged developer, right? Well, it actually turns out that designers go, product people go, business development people, and folks who are jacks of all trades. Twice now, I have to say that both my DNS and website hosting experience skills have come in handy at hackathons, so feeling quite good. And for this hackathon, I worked with Hadia, and we built, you know, an app from scratch, and I was really involved in the process. You know, I was in there doing my Ruby as well, so that it felt really, really good. So never feel intimidated that you won't fit in at a hackathon. Show up and enjoy it. I want to talk a little bit about kind of how a hackathon works and what you can expect. So hackathons usually occur on the weekend, and they're usually 24 to 48 hours. What the organizers are expecting you to do is to come to the event without really an idea in mind. They want you to get there, meet other people, and go ahead and get the idea off the ground at the hackathon, right? They don't want you to come with these canned ideas or something you've been already working on. The goal is to have fresh, creative, you know, communication and collaboration. Now, you can come with someone you know. In fact, at the Foursquare hackathon, I would say about two-thirds of the people came as teams. Hadia and I came as a team, so we had already planned to work together. But if we had found other people, then it would become a group of three or four. I have seen groups as large as 11, like when I was at Startup Weekend, but that's kind of the gist of it. Now, I'm going to be doing another video about how to rock a hackathon, so like when you arrive, how to introduce yourself and talk with other people and so on, right? So watch for that video as well. It's really interesting, like all sorts of companies, even Ford, they were offering a prize at TechCrunch's rep just finished this last week. And they didn't announce, this is the cool part, the prizes at these hackathons are getting pretty awesome. Sometimes it's a couple $100, sometimes it's a couple thousand, or in the case of the Foursquare contest, there are at least two trips that you can win to New York, one to meet the founders of Foursquare and another to meet with VC investors, right? So it's really making people step up their game. But with that being said, there's also a lot of flexibility. So at the TechCrunch hackathon, for example, they waited until the day before the hackathon to basically release all the prizes and competitions that were available. So then what companies do is they will often sponsor, whether it's a cash prize, there were several iPad 2s being offered at TechCrunch's rep. Maybe it is free use of technology or software, like Microsoft was doing for Bing. If you integrate their API, and one of the fellows at this hackathon won that. But so there's definitely an incentive. Plus, if you're already working with someone, then you get to know them a little bit better. I had a great time working with Hadia, and we got a lot done from Friday night until Sunday when we presented. So that basically wraps up like Hackathon 101. I would love to hear like what hackathons have you gone to? You know, when we talk about programming languages, I mean, everything from C++, right, to Objective-C. I mean, I suppose that there are even CSS hackathons, but obviously Ruby on Rails and Python and Java. I mean, the list goes on and on, as well as entire hackathons around, you know, specific products that are out there. So love to hear your comments, and I hope this video helps someone to have a better experience. And look for my other video, which I'll be doing right after. Thanks.